And now the film that's been blamed for the violence. The angry protests against the U.S. in Libya and Egypt are blamed in part on an amateur film called Innocence of Muslims, which ridicules the Prophet Muhammad. Now, I've watched the video. It's about 14 minutes long. It's supposedly a trailer for a longer film, and we have decided not to show it. But we can tell you that it's bizarre, and it portrays the Prophet Muhammad as gay, a child molester, and a, quote, murderous thug. It depicts Islam as a fraudulent religion. Out front tonight, Miguel Marquez. And Miguel, I know you spoke to an actress who worked on the film, had some of the hard and painful lines I just said there were among hers. What did she tell you?
Yeah. Well, she is horrified at what's happened, and the only reason she went on camera is because she is horrified by what's happened. She doesn't want her name used. She's afraid for her life, but she's more angry at what the filmmaker has done. She said she took a small role in this film, that she thought it was called Desert Warriors. That's how it was represented to her, that it was an adventure film set 2,000 years ago. There was no discussion of Muhammad in the film. She says the character that plays, that Muhammad was in the film, is actually named George in the film and was referred to either as Master George or Father Master during the film. She says that she was paid $500 for about 3 or 4 days of work on this film. She made a small, low-budget film, and she finds herself now in an international nightmare.
I would never be involved in a film to ever hurt or bring harm to anybody. And this makes me sick to my stomach to think that I was involved in that movie that brought death to somebody else. And I think it's unfair. I think it's very unfair. And I'm very sorry for that man, his family, and everybody else that was hurt. I really don't know what to say.
She is absolutely shocked by how this thing has taken off. This was a little tiny film. She also, during that interview, apologized to Muslims everywhere. She wants them to know that she and nor other actors had anything to do with this being a propaganda film or anti-Islam or political. None of that, she says, was what she got into this for. It was a simple film that she was making, and it has completely was misrepresented to her and changed after they had filmed their parts. Aaron?
Now, Miguel, I'm curious because, you know, watching it, there were a lot of people involved. Apparently, according to a statement CNN obtained on behalf of the 80 cast and crew members, the statement that they released to CNN said, quote, "The entire cast and crew are extremely upset and feel taken advantage of by the producer. We are 100% not behind this film and we're grossly misled about its intent and purpose." However, you know, when I watch it, they're talking about Muhammad, and not the Prophet Muhammad, but Muhammad, and they're talking about him being a child molester or being gay, and I'm wondering, do you believe this statement? Do you think that they possibly may not have known and really are upset? I mean, what's your take?
She says they did something called looping. They made the film, she came back later, and she did other lines. It is possible that some of those lines were also read by other people. If you watch that film, which just looks like a cheap, low-budget, you know,
yes,
it looks like a comedy more than anything.
Yes.
It appears that some of the lines have been completely dubbed over. She did say that she talked to Sam Basile, the film's producer today, who is defiant. He's been described as somebody who's in hiding and fearful for his life. But she says that this guy is defiant, that he says he's done this because he's tired of radical Islamists killing Americans, and that he is at fault for the movie. He is the writer. He said, "Don't let anyone blame you. It's me, the writer, Sam Basile, who is at fault here."